Oh, Jesus Christ.
Danny, are you willing to tell me why you're here tonight in Irondequoit?
We're here standing in solidarity and waiting to hear the news, and waiting to hear the family that's in the Border Patrol office here in Rochester. We're waiting for their release. They were detained in Geneseo for a minor traffic violation, and they have the potential of being deported and being separated. And that's just not okay. You know.
Thanks, Danny. Right, so anyone who's watching, what happened was there was a traffic violation in Geneseo. Two women and their five combined children were in the car, and now we're here in Irondequoit at a detention center for U.S. Customs and Border Protection, where we're hoping to see them released. Unfortunately, this is yet another example of local cooperation with federal authorities who are hostile to immigrants, and we have to understand that we've created this underclass of people who come from areas in Central America, like Guatemala, come from Honduras, come from Mexico, and drug violence in those countries, largely fueled by U.S. drug demand, has left them in an untenable position where they feel they have to leave. So, when they come here to escape that and send money back home, they face heavy penalties in the form of potential deportation. For people that think that's an acceptable risk, it needs to be pointed out once and again that the farmers who grow people on do this are accepting all of the reward for cheap labor and none of the risk. So there's probably 150 or 200 people here. Everyone's here in solidarity, including an amazing group of Geneseo students. So, once again, we're in Irondequoit. People have candles and are standing outside a U.S. Customs and Border detention station where two women and their children are being detained right now. A huge number of the almost 200
Thank you so much for coming out.
This is Carly Fox from the Working Justice
Center. I can't believe that we pulled this off. Tired, and we're not taking it anymore. Turn to me about, and I'll try to convey, and I'm under a lot of pressure to do it, is that they are here. Students who are going to volunteer and teach them English to the first SUNY Geneseo. migrant from and it's history. They were on their way to work and they were turned over to ICE. To all these people who want to learn English part of this country.
Yeah.
And then at 3 o'clock I brought the students. They met the kids, they met the moms. For one of them and said, Carly, I'm just pulled over by the police. And why we were pulled over, I don't know. I think we don't have enough car seats. I said, but that's she said, but I didn't know we needed one for the 4 years. She called me and said, they're right here at campus. I see police. We've been doing it for over a decade.
Shame! Shame!
We've done it. We just had a call. The leading dairy worker justice seekers were leaders of this region, who many of you have maybe seen and faces her final deportation. So this stuff's happening out of proportion, and I appreciate you all for coming out. They're going to probably release the children. But there was a two-month-old who was separated from her for over 3 hours. That two-month-old is a U.S. citizen child. There were, they were children who were just locked up. These are citizens, and that creates a clear generation of U.S. citizen kids and mixed. No criminal record of any of these folks. There's really crappy conditions in most agricultural. Go to a more desperate workforce who are in fear. In front of everyone and said, we pay $10 at my dairy. Is this the time? What a good farmer you are. Is this the time to be talking about the 2 month old?
Building
in
Rochester.
Stay
street.
And up Tuesday morning in a targeted. And so they're all invitations. Say Coyote Perez, who's been fighting for. They're telling me for 4 years you've got a wealth of students ready to stand. And we have that program. He's the reason we're all here. Judge in September, he was no longer in deportation. After our human rights activists. They're going after the people who are standing up. We're gonna keep fighting. This is not scaring the workers I work with. Their backs have been against. Three times a week. Sweet little peanut. And the 6 month Friday night. And then and the 2-year-old, and then there's Denise, widow of the founder of our amazing organization, and a huge mentor. So I would love.
La lucha continua. So. Stand and peel down what that really means. Power and building a workers' movement. Most workers and every worker, because when you're driving around in Wayne. See, they're in camp. regulations that protect and defend the health. Arm lobby. Around the country. The problem of the about what this means is when U.S. impoverished workers there. How are they going to fend and feed their families? Is false.
Right.
Workers that Carly and other folks work and do this work know those workers love their country. Have to understand that these are workers' lives. These are climate is getting dialed up. These folks are our enemy because they're in many instances these folks are families, they're our neighbors. To stand in solidarity with sisters.
Yeah. Woo!
The Trump administration and they're going to increase, my friends. In the labor movement, we have but we have a vision of how this can change, and that we have to cling to, where equality for these workers and for all. You have a contribution to struggle. Do not turn away from. With your neighbors about what your vision is. Of us are talking to the same folks who think with farm workers, which you are evidencing this evening. Fight back. Never give up.